Hey everyone, Mark Hockman here from PC World, where we're getting the first look at the performance numbers for the Qualcomm Snapdragon 8CX. So the Qualcomm Snapdragon 8CX was introduced last December at Qualcomm's Tech Summit in Hawaii, but now here at Computex, we're getting the first look at what this processor can actually deliver. So what you're looking at right now is Project Limitless. It sounds like a code name, but we're understanding that it's going to be an actual product that Lenovo should probably ship in 2020. It actually has an 8CX inside, and there's two aspects to it that we're concerned with. First, of course, is the actual performance of the processor. The second is the fact that it's running on a quote-unquote live 5G network here in Taipei. But really what we're interested in is actually what the numbers are going to deliver. So we've had a couple of generations of Snapdragon processors already, the last one being the 850. I can tell you from personal experience, it actually is quite competent in terms of running office apps and general web browsing. But the question has always been, how does it compare to a Core i5? So right now we have some numbers. So Qualcomm has actually run these numbers. We have to say that they've provided these benchmarks. They've run these numbers themselves. However, I think we can go ahead and trust them on this. So the numbers that we're comparing against are the 8CX versus a Core i5-8250U. That's the Kaby Lake R generation. We're not seeing any Whiskey Lake or Amber Lake numbers here. They tell us they're about comparable, so we have to take, take that at face value. So what we're running is both PC Mark 10, a new application benchmark. This is actually a benchmark that covers the Office apps, Excel, Word, Edge, and so forth. And what we're reporting, or what Qualcomm's reporting, is it's actually giving numbers of 4039 to 4139. That's a tad above what the Core i5-8250U is delivering, 3894 to 3970. So that's a good indication that performance is going to be comparable. The other thing that we need to be concerned with, of course, is battery life, and it's here that Qualcomm really excels. We're talking about a new battery life benchmark from PC Mark as well. They actually have a few tests that they run, but essentially they're delivering 17 hours to almost 20 hours of battery life running a video loop, which is what we do at PC World as well. If you're talking more about an actual real world apps demonstration, it's between 16 to 17 hours. Now, the other thing to think about is the Night Raid benchmark. That's a new benchmark that PC Mark, or actually runs under the 3D Mark, came out last year. And Night Raid is both runs both on ARM systems as well as Intel systems. Now, we're delivering a CPU score of 4431 to 4483 for the 8250U. That's a little bit higher than what the Snapdragon's delivering. But overall, because of the fact that it's actually running a more powerful version of its integrated GPU, we're seeing scores of about 5710 to 5815. That compares to about 5047 to 5055 for the 8250U. So again, substantially greater GPU performance. That should equate to perhaps not, say, Call of Duty level of performance in the PC Mark, but certainly quality graphics performance over time. So what we are seeing here is briefly a look at the 5G network here. We can see that 5G is the other aspect of Qualcomm's platform. The 8CX is part of what they call the Always Connected PC. What's nice about this is that it has both the X55 5G modem inside of it, as well as the older X24 LTE modem, essentially basically saying, okay, they can straddle both the LTE world as well as the emerging 5G market as well. So that is really what we came here to Computex to see, sort of the first performance indications from the 8CX, as well as essentially a product commitment from Lenovo to ship it.